الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته إن شاء الله يا سيسلام سيسلام بعد because he'd be upset is it because it's punish a Muslim day has anyone been punished yet may Allah protect you guys I mean you can smile and say salam a bit more energy so inshallah ta'ala today The event is called Fire in the Booth. Fire in the Booth, because obviously a booth is where you record music, you make songs inside of a music studio. And the reason we said fire is because music actually leads to the hellfire. People who listen to music, who make music, who indulge in music, who sell music, who buy music, who live that kind of a lifestyle, that lifestyle will lead you and take you into the hellfire. So that's the reason we call the event Fire in the Booth. So inshallah ta'ala, today I'm going to be talking about music from a particular angle. I'm going to be talking about music from the statements of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We always hear about this discussion about music. Is music haram? Some will tell you no, some will tell you yes. If it is haram, then they will tell you what kind of music is haram. This type is permissible. What about instruments? Can you use this instrument? Can you not use this instrument? What about this? What about that? Can you have halal hip hop? Can you have halal music? All this discussion goes on, right? And we're always quoting this sheikh said, this person said, that person said. So today, I thought to myself, right, let's just talk about what the Prophet said. Let's just stop talking about what he said. Let's literally go to the speech of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself and ask ourselves, what did the Prophet say? So I'm going to go through literally like five or six hadith on this issue. Maybe more, maybe less, depending on the time, inshallah ta'ala. And hopefully we'll try and learn and benefit exactly what it was that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had to say about music. And from each hadith we'll take benefits and understandings. There are those people that have this issue. They say, look, music is not mentioned in the Quran. And it is, by the way. It's mentioned in the Quran in five different places, okay? I have a video online in which I go through that. I mentioned the five different verses in the Quran in which music is mentioned. And it's actually more verses, but I only mentioned five. And it's 14 different hadith, and there is a unanimous agreement amongst all the scholars from the time of the Sahaba till now that music is haram in all of its forms. But that's in a video. If you want, you can check online. It's called, Is Music Really Permissible? Those who are watching on video, I'll put it on the link below, inshallah ta'ala. So it is in the Quran. But let's just say for argument's sake it wasn't. Would that affect us? No. Because the hadith is taken the same way the Quran is taken. Both the hadith and the Quran are from Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he didn't speak from his own desires. In huwa illa wahyu yuha. Rather, the speech that he is talking, his hadith, his sunnah, is actually from Allah. It's revelation. Both the Quran and the sunnah from Allah. The only difference is the Quran is the actual speech, the spoken word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the hadith is where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is being taught and he's explaining it. And instead, if we say the same way Jibreel came down to the Prophet to teach him Quran, is the same way Jibreel came down to the Prophet to teach him the hadith. And the hadith and the surah and the Quran both came to you from the Sahaba. So how can you accept one and reject the other? In fact, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prophesied that a day like this would come. The hadith is Sunan Abi Dawud, Imam Ahmad in his Musnad also narrated. But the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam said, أَلَا وَإِنِّي أُوتِيتُ الْكِتَابَ وَمِثْلُهُ مَعَهُ The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that I was given the Quran, the Kitab, وَمِثْلُهُ مَعَهُ And I was given something like it, with it. So he's saying, I've got the Quran and I've got something like it. So the hadith is like the Quran. It's like it in what though? It's like it in terms of implementation. The same way you hear an ayah, you have to implement it. The same way you hear a hadith, you have to implement it. The two will never contradict each other. And the two will be implemented in exactly the same way. They'll be implemented in exactly the same way. So even if there was no verses in the Quran that dealt with music, and it was only hadith that dealt with music, we would take it. Because it's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, provided the hadith is authentically been transmitted. Does that make sense? Good. So with that said, inshallah ta'ala, let's go for some hadith. The first hadith I'm going to mention talks about the punishment of those who listen to music. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, it's in Sahih al-Bukhari. He said, لَيَكُونَنَّ مِنْ أُمَّتِي أَقْوَامٌ The Prophet said, there will be. And the wording he used, لَيَكُونَنَّ is emphasis. He's saying there will be. Certainly there will be. Without a shadow of a doubt there will be. In my ummah, a particular type of people. This is going to happen. What the Prophet is saying about these people is going to happen. Who are they? The Prophet describes. يَسْتَحِلُّونَ الْحِرَى They will make zina halal. What's zina? Zina is a man and a woman sleeping with each other. A man and woman fornicating, doing haram. The Prophet said it will happen with certainty that they will make it halal. Wal khamra. And they will make alcohol halal. Pay attention. The zina here. Remember the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in another hadith that we're going to come to later, that the zina is of types. There's the real zina when a man actually will enter and penetrate inside of a woman. But it is also the zina which is not the literal zina, but it's that which will lead to zina. It's looking at the haram, speaking to the haram, touching the haram. If a man goes up to a woman, he touches her, hugs her, kisses her, this is a form of zina, because that's ultimately going to lead to it. So are we not seeing this in front of us already? Are we not seeing people making zina halal? Like, people are out there saying there's nothing wrong with looking at a girl. Furthermore, a girl will allow herself to be looked at by not wearing a hijab, but putting on makeup. She's emphasizing her beauty. What do you mean? This is not makeup, this is natural makeup. It's still makeup though, right? And she's saying it's permissible. Rather, she's got sheikh, scholars she's quoting, who are passing fatwa, saying there's nothing wrong with this. You could wear these tight clothes, you could wear this kind of hijab, you know, hijab with a little hair flicking out here. She's actually allowing man to look at her. She's okay with the zina. Does that make sense? They made it halal from that angle. And eventually we'll come to a time where I promise you, they will actually say that a man actually penetrating a woman is going to be halal as well. It's going towards that. The Prophet prophesies this. The next thing the Prophet said is al-khamr, which is alcohol. Now, we haven't got to a stage where people are fully out there saying alcohol is permissible. We haven't. But we've got lots of people that are talking about weed being permissible, right? Some people say this a lot. Talk about drugs. Is it like weed? Weed is just, it's a plant. It's just from the ground. It's something natural. Right? They say this, right? Now, how am I talking about weed when the hadith mentioned alcohol? Because the Prophet ﷺ told us that the reason alcohol is haram is why? It's because it's an intoxicant. Alcohol will get you drunk. It will intoxicate your mind. So then the Prophet said in another narration, anything that also has the same effect that intoxicates your mind is haram. So whatever it is that the people are smoking or taking or drinking or sniffing nowadays, as long as it changes your mental state, it's all haram. Whether it's weed, whether it's heroin, whether it's this laughing gas thing, whether it's qad, whatever it might be, all of these things that alter a person's mental state, they all fall under this. And people are telling you it's halal. Like the qad thing, the people will tell you that's halal, there's nothing wrong with it. People will tell you the weed, there's nothing wrong with it. Again, we're seeing what the Prophet said manifest before our very own eyes. Wal ma'azifa. Musical instruments, the Prophet said. This will happen. People will make musical instruments, they'll make it halal. They'll make it halal. Do we not see this today? We've got these idiots online. They call themselves Deen Squad. But really, they're Iblis Squad. They're Shaitan Squad. They are Shaitan Squad. Why? Because, as you're going to learn in the other lecture, inshallah ta'ala, music, one of its names is Mu'adhin al-Shaytan. You know, the Mu'adhin is one who gives the Adhan. One of its names is the one who gives the adhan of shaitan. He calls the call of shaitan. Another name for music, as you learn inshallah ta'ala, is Quran of shaitan. We have our Quran, the Quran of Allah, right? And there's a Quran of shaitan. Allah says, وَفْتَزِّزْ مَنِ اسْتَطَعْتَ مِنْهُمْ بِصَوْتِكَ. He tells shaitan to affect the people with his voice. What's his voice? His voice is music. I didn't say the Sahaba explained it in this way. The Sahaba were told to follow explained it in this way. So these people, they're not Deen Squad. They're Iblis. They are Iblis Squad. They are Shaitan Squad. That's what they are. There's no two ways about it, right? But the interesting thing here is this. What do they call their music? They call it halal hip hop. What does the Prophet say? يستحلون الحرى والحريرة, which I forgot to mention. I'll mention in a second. والخمر والمعازف. They make halal the musical instruments, and they call it halal hip hop. They call it halal hip hop. Exactly what the hadith talking about, right? And then, which I forgot to mention earlier, the hadith mentions silk. Silk. Men are not allowed to wear silk. Now you've got men wearing proper silk ties and this, that, and the other. Like, silk has become a happy days thing. People wearing them to work, wearing them to school, whatever have you. Wearing silk, right? The Prophet ﷺ said these people, after he mentioned this, that this will become halal, then he mentioned there's going to be a group of people who are indulging in these things. They're going to be on the side of a mountain, and they're listening to their music, they're getting drunk, they're fornicating with their women. It's a rave, it's a party. Hadith doesn't mention that, but it's kind of that kind of scene, right? They're drinking, they're smoking, they're having sexual intercourse, right? And they're wearing silk maybe, right? So which means that they're behaving like women. which we have this homosexuality thing, right? This feminine thing. Nowadays, men want to all act like women. Men want to move like females, right? Starts off by wearing silk, next thing you know, he shaves his beard. Some brothers, wallahi, they're so pretty without a beard that if you put a hijab on, wallahi, I don't know if to lower my gaze or not. Because I'm thinking maybe you're a sister. Sometimes, have you ever had it where a guy comes to you, shake your hand, but you're like, are you a woman or are you a guy? So I don't know if I should shake his hand. Because of course I can't touch a woman. That's what I'm saying. But I'm like, I don't know if you're a guy. Do you understand? And sometimes a woman might come to you, she looks so manly. And you might think, oh, let me shake her hand. But then you're like, oh, this is a sister. Not sister, but like a female, because inshallah sisters, you know, it's pretty clear. The point is, yeah, that's what it leads to. So you've got these people who are there. They're smoking, they're drinking. Not smoking, but they're intoxicating. They're fornicating. What are they doing? Assalamu alaikum. What are they doing? They're fornicating. They're listening to musical instruments. They're having a party. And they've got some feminine kind of characteristics, maybe, because they've got this silk and whatnot. So what's going to happen to them? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, and I'm going to miss out a particular part of the hadith just because we don't have much time. I'm going to go to the part that's directly relevant to us today that I want to address. But the Prophet said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because remember I said they're on the corner of a mountain, right? Allah will cause the mountain to collapse on them. Allah will take the mountain, the mountain will fall on top of their heads. But there will be a group of people that will be left. The mountain didn't touch them. So what happened to them? وَيَمْسَخُ آخَرِينَ قِرَدَةٍ وَخَنَازِيرَ إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ The Prophet ﷺ said that the ones who are left, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will transform them. He will deform them into monkeys and pigs. And they remain like that to the day of judgment. So the scholars, they discuss now, is this an actual literal transformation? They will literally become monkeys and pigs? Or is it like they will start to behave like monkeys and pigs? Now generally speaking, if a hadith is mentioned, we take it as apparent that Allah will actually transform them into pigs and monkeys. They literally, you'll see him one day as a human. He's raving, he's shacking out, drinking, smoking, sleeping, what? And suddenly, Allah's going to turn him into a pig or a monkey. Or her into a pig or a monkey. It will actually happen like that. But what's powerful is that if you reflect, you can kind of see this transformation already taking place. You can kind of see this transformation already taking place. What are some of the characteristics of a pig? That he doesn't care if another man sleeps with his woman, right? He doesn't care. A pig man will not care if another man comes and has sex with his pig wife. So, now you see these guys, these musicians who listen to music. He's married. He's married. And this Jay-Z guy's married to Beyonce. And he'll be happy and comfortable her being in video with next man grinding on her and whatnot and so on and so forth. And the people who listen to this are exactly the same. Now you see the people who listen to music are less likely to have a problem when another man looks at his wife. They're less likely to have a problem when another man will come and kiss his wife on the cheek or shake his wife's hands. Are you mad? The youth is a man who... The man will not go to Jannah. A man who lets a next man look at his wife, touch his wife, see his wife. This is something that happens to people who listen to music, and it's a characteristic of the pig. We can already see it happening. As for the monkey, wallah, have you ever seen a baboon? The baboon, what? His butt is always hanging out, right? And look at these rappers, they always wear their trousers low. They always got their trousers low. Why do you want your butt to hang out? And that's something that came from jail, by the way, as well. Yeah? It was to let man know, listen, I take it there. So you don't have to worry. Like, I'm ready for you. And then they wear it. Again, like I told you, you're going to see some themes throughout this lecture. Music, zina, homosexuality, they're all linked. It's all linked. These are things that are all linked with each other. So it happens. It happens, right? Not only that, look at the way these guys are jumping around. The way one guy will be rapping. He's throwing his hands there. Wallahi, you think about it, this guy is moving like a monkey. He's actually throwing his hands in the air like a monkey. He's doing everything except like just making the sounds. Furthermore, you've got some of these guys that start behaving like dogs. DMX will tell you, I'm the dog. He'll start barking like a dog. The guy will bark like a dog. Do you understand? So I'm saying we're already seeing these transformations happen in front of our very own eyes. Well, I was shocked when the guys, they watch it online, will place a video clip right here for them to see. But there was an interview where there was a rapper, okay? I won't mention his name in case you guys Google him, so you search him up. But you know, alhamdulillah, he's in jail now, doing life, alhamdulillah. So this person was doing an interview for a record label, right? And now you got all these people here who are at this record label. They're watching him perform, and you got bare. It's all just white people, by the way. Not that I'm not saying any racist kind of way, but to show you the mentality that you know, it's like you got this African-American guy and he's performing for these white people. Like they were looking at him like he was an animal in the zoo. But like they had a pen, papers, not assessing him. They're looking at him. And this guy is doing mad things. He's just, he's doing this, he's jumping on the table, he's flipping, back flipping. He's going crazy. Wallahi, he looks like an absolute, he looks like an absolute animal. He looks like he's literally been, all he's missing is what? Is the full kind of, you know, mutation of into a monkey. But he's actually behaving like that, as the hadith mentioned, right? And they're just looking at him. They're observing him as if you would be in a zoo watching a person. Like, wallahi, the transformation has already happened. It's already starting to happen. All that's missing is literally for man to just have the fur and the tail and for things to just happen. Overnight it will happen like that. So that's what the hadith mentioned. They'll be like this to the day of judgment. Another hadith for the Prophet ﷺ, he mentioned, لَا يَشْرَبَنَّ نَاسٍ مِنْ أُمَّةِ الْخَمْرَ. The people from our ummah will be drinking, they'll be drinking alcohol. People from our ummah will be drinking alcohol. What will happen to them? يُسَمُّونَهَ بِغَيْرِ اسْمِهَا. They will not call it alcohol, they'll call it something else. And pay attention, this is one of the tricks of shaitan. And this hadith is an evidence that we use for it. By the way, this hadith is Ibn Majah, the one I'm mentioning to you. Sunan Ibn Majah, Imam al-Bani, rahimahullah, sahahahu. He made it authentic, rahimahullah ta'ala. So what is it? That they call it by other than its name. And this is a common, common thing that shaitan does. Like when something's haram, like no one's going to do it when it's got that evil kind of name. So what we'll do is change the name. When you change the name, it starts to become okay. Like homosexuality was called what before? Does anyone know what it was called before? Does anyone know what it was called before? Anyone know what homosexuality used to be called? Sodomy. As a sodomite. He sodomizes. He gets sodomized. That sounds mad. That sounds mad, right? So what do? They change the word to gay. What does gay mean? It means happy. Well, I literally, they just changed the name in broad daylight. Now, what do you mean? Happy, bruv, you're a sodomite. You're sodomizing. You get sodomized. What do you change to that? Another word, well, when a man and woman, they do zina with each other, what do they call it? He says, I'm making love. That sounds so nice. Bruv, you're fornicating. You're a fornicator. You're a fornicator. He says, I'm sleeping. It sounds so harmless. We slept together last night. What do you mean you slept? You fornicated, bruv. You fornicated with each other last night. Shaitan does this. Okay, shaitan does this. But alcohol is the same thing. People, what do they call it? Well, our names are alcohol, they call it juice. They call it drink. Fam, let me get some drink from the store. Bring me some juice. Then they call it that. They put all of these names for alcohol, they call it Malibu. Malibu just sounds like such a nice name. Like Malibu is a nice beach in America, you know, with a little sunset. But it's the devil's drink. You might have drinking it. Allah called it abomination of shaitan. But they changed the name. They do the same with drugs. What do they call drugs now? Food. That man's hungry. Like, food. Like a funny story, Ustad Abdurrahman, you know, a guy came to him one time, he was coming out the ATM, he pulled out some money, and he went to basically turn around, and the guy came up to him, he's like, hey fam, you said, like, no, sorry, he came out the chicken shop, and he had food, he had chicken and chips. So as he come out the shop, a guy comes up to him and goes, yo fam, you said, you got any food for me? So Ustad kind of looked at his chicken and chips, was like, he didn't take the food. The guy's like, no, I mean drugs, innit? And that's the day he learned what they call it. So they changed the name. And they changed the name to make it sound more acceptable. Do you understand? So that's what, even with music, they do this, right? What do they call music now? Like music. They change its name. They call it halal hip-hop. They change the name. Hip-hop is satanic. It's satanic. He just, by putting halal, he changed the name. Now everyone, suddenly, to show you how powerful this is, suddenly everyone wants to do it. So the thing is, the Prophet said that they're going to be drinking and they're going to change the name. Exactly what we see today. And يُعْزَفُ عَلَى رُؤُوسِهِمْ بِالْمَعَازِفِ وَالْمُغَنِّيَاتِ. Pay attention. What will happen? The musical instruments will be played for these people. They're drinking, sipping. Musical instruments are playing for them. And what? الْمُغَنِّيَاتِ. And you've got chicks that are dancing for them. These girls, they're dancing. Pay attention. As we're going to find later, the Prophet ﷺ used a word for these dancing girls that also means prostitute. And there's a huge link between women being loose and music. And there's actually a study. Well, I'll link the study at the bottom of the video because I was just looking at it before, I forgot the name. But it was a research that was done to see if music like causes women to become more promiscuous, become more sexually engaged. And you know what they found was that music does. When women listen to music, they become more sexually engaged than a man would. So it makes them more loose. It makes them into more of a hoe, basically. right? So when she's out there in the club and she's listening to music, the alcohol is going to make her act one way, and then also the music is going to add to it. Music actually causes women to act more promiscuous. So come back to the hadith. The Prophet is setting a scene for you. People are drinking alcohol, okay? And they're changing the name of the alcohol to something else. And music is being played for them. Music is being played for them. And girls are out there, they're singing for them. And these are loose chicks, right? Is that not what a club is like? Is that not a club scene? Is that not like a rave or a shubs? Is that not exactly what it is? People in a club drinking, smoking, dancing, girls, da da da. And all the time they're changing the name. He's drinking, he's calling it juice. He's fornicating, he's calling it love. Yeah? And they're doing music and they're calling it, we're just vibing out here, we're just vibing. All of that is happening. The hadith of Allah is haq. The Prophet Isa Sam is proof that he's a messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What happened to them? يَخْسِفُ اللَّهُ بِهِمُ الْأَرْضَ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will cause the earth to swallow them. وَيَجْعَلُ مِنْهُمُ الْقِرَادَةَ وَالْخَنَازِيرُ And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will cause them to become monkeys and pigs. Allah will cause them to become monkeys and pigs. Another hadith the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned, again, إِنَّ فِي أُمَّتِي خَصْفًا وَمَسْخًا وَقَدْفًا That verily in my ummah there will be a, like the earth will swallow. وَمَسْخًا There will be a deformation, people will be deformed. وَقَدْفًا There will be a bombing, people will be bombed from top. They'll be pelted, things will come from the sky, they'll be thrown down onto them. قَالُوا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ وَهُمْ يَشْهَدُونَ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ The Sahaba said, Ya Rasulullah, would these people, would they be Muslim, would they testify and bear witness, لا إله إلا الله? And the Prophet said, Na'am, they will be. They're Muslims. These are Muslims. Wallahi, pay attention. And this is going to be a bit of a sensitive topic, and I don't want people to get offended or upset. But we just have to say the haq like it is. Look at all the Muslim countries in which bombs are flying, being rained down. Well, if you go to the same Muslim countries before the bombs are flying, you see these people were living it up with music. Their music and the music of the kuffar. I'm telling you something, in my country, Pakistan, there were many drone strikes. And like I said, I'm not saying this because I'm talking bad of our countries, but it's a reality. I'm just trying to make you understand and reflect. Pakistan is a country in which drone strikes violated that place in particular regions. Wallahi, I remember when I was a kid. May Allah forgive me, when I was a kid, 7, 8 years old, I was into music from young. Wa'iyadu billah. You know what? You know where I bought all my albums from? You know where I bought all my tapes from? Pakistan. I remember driving through Lahore. I know you might have thinking, rah, Lahore, like, you know, bad, bad, ding, ding. Driving through Lahore, and there's graffiti, like, people, Tupac's alive, Tupac's coming back. This is in Lahore. It's in Lahore. And wallahi, I remember back then we never had CDs. We had Walkman. Does anyone remember a Walkman? Anyone seen a Walkman in their life? Put your hand up. You seen a Walkman? Walkman with the cassette tapes, right? So I used to buy Snoop Dogg, Dr. Dre, Exhibit, Tupac. I used to buy all them tapes. I bought them all from there. They were cheap. That's what I learned music was from there. A brother of ours, he took a picture of it and he took it off his Facebook. Otherwise, I would have showed it for the ones who are watching the video. But he went to the West Bank, the part that's occupied of Palestine. Where Masjid Al-Aqsa and all that is. And he said, well, he saw graffiti on the wall. People were graffitiing Kim Kardashian. Kim Kardashian. And then what's happening? Then we're complaining why they're being occupied and why bombs are dropping from above. Now, I'm not saying that the Prophet ﷺ here is talking about this is the way that the people are going to be punished. That, you know, bombs are going to actually come. We don't know how, because it could be Tayran Ababil, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the birds who drop the pellets and whatnot, and then, you know, when the people tried to invade the Kaaba. Because we can't say that. The hadith and the Prophet left it ambiguous. He did it for a reason, which means we can't now force a meaning onto it and say that. But the point I'm saying is that these are all reflections and ponderances and things that are real around us, and we really need to just take into consideration, right? And what will happen? The Prophet said, this will happen when? إِذَا ظَهَرَتِ الْمَعَازِفِ وَالْخُمُورِ وَلَبْسُ الْحَرِيرِ If it becomes apparent amongst the people, musical instruments, alcohol, and people wearing harir. Now, I just want to just quickly end by mentioning a few points. Notice that and then we'll conclude. I had a lot more hadith to go through, but time doesn't allow. So I just want to finalize and conclude on this point here. These hadith that I mentioned, especially going to the first one, the Prophet ﷺ said that what's going to happen? That it's going to become what? It's going to become halal. To show you that it is haram. If it wasn't haram, why would the Prophet say that people will make it halal? Not only that, the Prophet ﷺ, he linked it to what? He linked it to alcohol and fornication and wearing silk, which is a feminine thing that only only women do, men don't wear silk. So in other words, something that is feminine that could lead to homosexuality, fornication, zina, alcohol and music are in the same category. And the Prophet connected them by the wow. The wow, if you learn Arabic grammar, it shows something called atf, which means connection. That what these things are connected. So the Prophet connected all these four and gave them all the same ruling, which means these four are going to be punished in this way. And all these four are going to be seen to be halal. And the only reason he said they're going to be seen to be halal is because they're haram in the first place. Does that make sense? So people to argue this is an absolute joke. The next point, literally just two quick points I want to make like this and we're done inshallah ta'ala. The next point is, what does it mean that they will make it halal? What does it mean that they will make it halal? The first thing that it means is that the people will actually say this is halal, but deep down in their heart they know it's haram. But out of arrogance they will say it's halal. That's the first one. He'll actually say it, but he doesn't believe it. Number two, a person will believe it's halal because he heard a fatwa of some misguided sheikh. Some misguided sheikh. He heard a fatwa from him, right? He basically said, oh, music is permissible, blah, 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 and then he started to do it. So he got a shubha. He got a ta'wil that's fasid. He got interpretations corrupted. And because of that, he started to believe that it was halal. The third thing that it could mean, that the scholars they put down, is that it means that a person is listening to music and out and all of this. He's doing this alcohol, zina, music, wearing silk so much. He's doing it so much out in the open that a person who walks by will look at it and think, oh, it's halal. Because a person hides sins, you hide sins, you hide evil. So because he's doing it so much out there, is that people walking by will think this man's just made it halal, it's halal now. So it could mean any of these things. And I tell you something, brothers, wallahi, something to be scared of. And wallahi, for these people, this Iblis squad and all these other nasheed artists who are not really doing nasheed, they're doing music, clear-cut music, right? All these dons, what they're doing. And those who are not even saying it's nasheed, all of them, they need to fear Allah. Because this thing about making something halal when it's haram can lead to kufr. It can lead to kufr. If the evidence has been established on you and you're still arguing with it, you could become a kafir if you make something halal which Allah made haram. This book, I always carry it with me, and I always tell you guys to study this book, memorize this book, learn this book. In it, the first thing you study is Nawaqid al-Islam, the 10 nullifiers of Islam. Is the thing that you study, the 10 nullifiers of al-Islam. Okay? The fourth one, al-Rabi'u, man i'taqada anna ghayra haddi al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam akmalu min haddihi wa anna hukma ghayrihi ahsanu min hukmihi kalladhin yufadiluna hukma tawaghita ala hukmihi fahuwa kafir. Anyone who prefers the law of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or believes another law is better or more complete than the law of Allah or what the Prophet came with, then that person is a kafir. This is by ijma', person left the fold of Islam. That person left the fold of Islam, okay? Now, of course, a person ruling by other than Allah's law is of types. There's some types where you don't necessarily become a kafir. That's where the takfiris go wrong, okay? And then there's types where a person does become a kafir. From the ones where a person does become a kafir is if the evidence has been established upon him, he's not doing it out of ignorance, he's not being forced, yet he's still saying this is halal when it's clearly haram. He's a kafir now. He's a kafir. And the penultimate thing that I wanted to mention to you guys, inshallah ta'ala, is that these two, three hadith that I mentioned to you are a proof that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the Messenger of Allah. He's a messenger. If there was no other hadith, in fact, to be honest, it's interesting because the scholars would say about this one hadith that I mentioned first, if there was no other hadith that told us about music being haram, then we wouldn't need any other hadith because this hadith is so clear. There doesn't need to be no other ayah, no other hadith, no enough. Just this hadith is enough to show you that it's haram. Okay? And to be honest, Qadr Allah, I only got to mention that one hadith with its different chains. With its different wordings. I didn't actually mention more. I just mentioned that one hadith in three different ways with different information here and there. But the point is that Qadr Allah, we didn't get to mention it, but we don't need to mention it. But this hadith is a proof that what the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the Messenger of Allah and it's true. And I'll conclude by just mentioning an ayah from the Quran at the end of Surah Al-Najm, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to the people that you're laughing. وَلَا تَبْكُونَ. But you're not crying. You should be crying, people. Brothers, sisters, we should be crying. We've done sins. We've done all sorts of madness. Our death is close. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if you knew what I knew, you would laugh little and cry much. You would laugh little and cry much. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, that you're laughing, you're joking. وَلَا تَبْكُونَ, you're not crying. Not only that, وَأَنْتُمْ سَامِدُونَ. And on top of that, you guys are making music. You're singing, you're dancing, music. سَامِدُونَ, Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu said, this means in the dialect of the Yemeni Arabs, the Himyar dialect, it means music. It means ghina, one of the two. But it's the same thing basically. He said, this is it. Allah is saying, look, you guys are supposed to be crying. You might have come with sins. You've done all sorts of problems. You're supposed to be finished. You're supposed to be out here crying, but you're laughing, you're joking. Not only that, you're coming with music. وَأَنْتُمْ سَامِدُونَ. Rather, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells you, فَاسْجُدُوا لِلَّهِ وَعْبُدُوا. Make sajda to Allah. وَعْبُدُوا. Worship Him alone. Worship Him alone, because that's the only way you'll be saved. This ayah, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed it in Mecca, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed it in Mecca, all of the kuffar of Quraysh, even the ones that were kuffar, Abu Jahl, all of them, it was so powerful that they all fell into sajda. And it's from the sunnah that when you hear this ayah, you also do sajda. So everyone do sajda, inshallah ta'ala. It's a quick little sunnah go forth. Shall I make sajda? And then we'll end the talk here. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. Hey guys, I really hope that you benefited from that video. Before you go, I want to ask you a really important question. Have you guys ever thought about studying Islam and seeking knowledge? If not, then I want you to reflect upon this hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet said that seeking knowledge is obligatory upon every single Muslim. Of course, that doesn't mean you have to be a scholar, but you have to know the basics in order for you to be the best possible slave and worshipper of Allah that you can possibly be. So we decided to provide a solution for this. You see, many people want to study, but they don't have the means or the resources to do so. So we set up an online institute called the Knowledge College, where you can study Islam from the comfort of your own home. So if you want more information on the Knowledge College and you'd like to sign up, go to the link below, check out the website, and hopefully we see you on the other side. Assalamu alaikum.